Hello guys, welcome to another video. In this video we are going to learn how to retrieve and display data from Firebase database, okay, in your Android application. So without wasting much more time, let's start the video here, okay. So before starting today's application development, let's take a look on our previous application development which we have done in our previous video, okay. So here you can see whatever you will write here, it will be saved to your database, okay. You can see here, yeah. So that's it all about our previous application in which we have learned how to write something into your database, okay. So in this video we are going to fetch, or you can say retrieve, that data into our Android application, okay. So let's start the video here. So here just copy that button, we will take another button for list data, okay. Yeah, that's it, just align the button, yeah, below submit, fine. We'll take another icon for this, yeah, that's it, all about our layout file. Let's go to the main activity. Here you can see another button, list, just initialize it here, find by id, add data id dot list data, okay. After that just set the unclick listener here, set unclick listener, new view dot unclick listener, fine. So here insert that, we will create an intent. So intent is equal to new intent of main activity dot this. Here we will take another activity for new operations, fine, empty activity. Here you can say a retrieve activity, or you can say a data activity for retrieving purpose. Yeah, that's it. Here is our data activity, just say a data activity dot class. Yeah, start activity, just pass the intent here. Yeah, that's it all about our main activity. Let's modify the UI part, just change it to relative layout. Just drag a recycler view here, you can name it as list view, okay. Yeah, that's it. Before proceeding further, we will add some implementations, okay. So here I have copied this, just paste it inside build.gradle, okay. Just say sync now, yeah, that's it. We can initialize our recycler view here, we can take recycler view list view, yeah, you can say view R view, okay. Yeah, so another thing you have to take, private database reference root ref, okay. So just initialize these two inside on create method, R view equals to find view id r dot id dot list view, okay. Yeah, that's it. Root ref equals to Firebase database dot get instance dot get reference, fine. So here you can say R view dot set layout manager, new linear layout manager, you can say, just pass the context as this, okay. So here we can take another method, public void gain data, okay. Yeah, inside this we can say final Firebase recycler, okay, it's not coming, just type it, Firebase recycler options, import the class. Here we can say object options, okay. Yeah, equals to new Firebase recycler options. Here you can say dot builder dot set query. Inside the query you can pass our database reference root ref comma model, okay, which is nothing but object dot class. At last you can say dot build, okay. Yeah, Firebase recycler option is completed. Next one we can take final Firebase recycler adapter, Firebase recycler adapter, okay. Seems it's not coming automatically, let me type. Yeah, so here you can say object comma, okay, just we have to take another inner class, okay, which will be our holder, public static class data view holder, you can say extends recycler view dot view holder, okay. Yeah, where is view holder, that's it. Yeah, inside this you can declare a variable text view data, okay. Before proceeding further, I will take another layout for displaying the data, okay. So here you can say data display, or you can say data view layout, okay. Yeah, that's it. Just change the constant layout here, just take card view here for better UI, okay. So take another XML namespace, here you can say app, okay. Just select this race auto, okay. Yeah, that's it. We can take card corner radius here, yeah, I will set it to 4 dp, just delete this app. Okay, yeah. So next one I will take card elevation, also 4 dp. okay, you can also take here outline spot, shadow color, okay, which will be primary. Yeah, that's it. Inside this you can take linear layout, match parent, you can say 40 dp. fine. So here I will set orientation, okay, to horizontal, and just collapse this empty tag. Fine, that's it. Just you can add here a text view also inside the linear layout. For that we have to open the tag. Fine, here you can say text view, match parent, and wrap content. Okay, delete this one. Fine. Yeah, I have missed the text view here. Okay, just write it. Fine, design part. Here I can design it to match parent. I will say the ID as data. Yeah, that's it. Here you can say get the constructor of this data view holder. Okay, so you can say private data view holder. Inside that view item view. Okay, just let me open the constructor body here. Inside that we can super call, yeah, data equals to item view dot find view by id. You can say add dot id dot data. Yeah, that's it. All about our inner class. Here you can pass that inner class. Okay, just import this class. You can say adapter equals to new Firebase recycler adapter. Yeah, that's it. We got our overridden methods. Inside this we can perform our retrieval operations. Just say options here. Yeah, that's it. So here we have to add value event listener. Okay, so I will add value event listener on our reference, which is nothing but root ref dot add value event listener. Inside that you can say new value event listener. We got our operated methods here. So you can say a string data equals to data snapshot dot child. You can say data dot get value dot to string. Okay, yeah, that's it. We can set the data to our view holder. Okay, so data view holder dot data dot set text. Inside that we can pass data. Okay, fine. So let's come here. You can say here view equals to layout inflator dot from. Inside that you can say parent dot get context dot inflate r dot layout dot data display layout comma view group is parent comma you can say attached to root is false. Fine. So after that you can return data view holder view. Fine. So here just end with semicolon. After that just set the adapter to our recycler view, r view dot set adapter. Adapter, okay, yeah, adapter dot start listening. Fine. So that's it. Just call our method here, get data. Fine, we have completed our retrieval part. You can just run the application here. Say run the application, just wait for some time, it will be installed soon. Fine, let's see what happens. Yeah, installed successfully. So here you can enter the new data. I will say my name only. You can see the database is fetched with new data. Just let's see our application will be fetched or not. Yeah, it's coming but bit small. Okay, let me increase the font of that. Yeah, just go to activity data, activity view layout. Okay, so here we can say the text alignment center. You can say here the text bold, text size is 18. Yeah, here I will say data. Fine. Here we can add some padding for better view. Where is the padding? Yeah, here you can set the padding. I will take 5 dp. yeah, it's coming nicely now. Just run the application again. It will take a bit time. Okay. Yeah, installed successfully. Fine, let's try again. We will, yeah, you can see here we have retrieved successfully our data. Just let's see with another data. So here I will pass another new name. So I will pass here AIT, just push the data. So here you can see the new data is coming. We have successfully retrieved. Retrieving text is not a big deal, okay? So I have prepared that much complex code because for future understanding, we will retrieve some images, some audio files, some video files. So that's it for today's video. We will meet in another video. If you like this video, give a thumbs up and please subscribe to the channel. Thank you.